as far as I'm concerned, I have the best job in the world. I get to travel around the world. I get to see all these wonderful places. We don't often get a great deal of time because when, you know, most of it is working. It's long hours, but it's incredibly rewarding. It's all about what everybody hears. That's as a sound engineer, that's what we do. The band plays and we translate that. All aspects of audio over the last 25 years. I've done TV, I've done films, I've done live radio, and I keep coming back to live sound engineering. And for me, it's because of the buzz. You've got to get it right on the night, every time. There's no second chance. I've never really been into studio recording. I don't like the repetitive nature of it. You've got to go over the same piece time and time again, and it's, you know, the devil is in the details. But live sound engineering for me is, it's a buzz. It's like, you know, jumping out of a plane, or you've got to get it right. I think the biggest challenge is keeping everybody happy, especially as a monitor engineer, because I look after what the artist hears on stage. And obviously with One Direction, I have five main artists and then the band as well. So I run 14 mixes on stage every night that I have to monitor and make sure everyone can hear whatever they need to hear. And of course, when you're working in such a loud environment, that can sometimes be difficult. It's all a technical challenge, which is good. I think people that go into this industry generally like to learn and enjoy learning, because you will every day something new. You'll have to learn it. I think the days of falling into a profession like this are gone. I think you have to have the requisite skills in learning to be able to go forward nowadays. People don't just come along and say, I'd like to do that, I'll be a sound engineer. I think those days are gone. I think you've got to start young and in school, extremely proud to be an engineer. Yeah.